7 seconds in today's world is a long time.
Hey there. It's Scott again, the reluctant editor. In the last episode, I made a quick little video about a motorcycle ride with some buddies. This time, I want to make it a bit prettier, so I'm going to give it a nice title. There are like infinity different ways to create a title, and I'm going to invent one of them right now, but I have some goals. It should be animated. It should be not basic. It should have some style, and it should vibrate for the piece. Right out of the gate, I know I'm gonna have to choose a different font. I land on one pretty quickly here.
A pretty tough looking font.
A fat, all caps typeface called Bungie. Fonts are something a lot of people have strong opinions about. So love it or hate it, I'm using Bungie. Now it's time to start thinking about the styles. I'm honestly having a pretty tough time getting to something that I like here, but fortunately Terri is about to show up.
A drop shadow is a natural look that is going to shadow onto a surface. It makes me come out of the story and kind of think logically, oh, where's that shadow? How's that shadow getting on the truck and the snow and stuff? Anyway, I think it would be cool if we filled this text with some other video. And to do that, we're gonna want to fill this text with a color that we can key out. Right. So I'm going to start by, let's make this a bright green because we know there's no other green in that scene. And then, because that would be still quite flat, we're gonna want to put an edge color on there too. That's okay, but it's not really flashy. I feel like with the music you have and it's motorcycles, you're gonna want something more, brighter. Mm-hmm. So maybe, and that's not even really that bright. So maybe I'd just pick something, you know, maybe even kind of radical. Let's go over and see what you've got for keyframes. So on this, looks like, let's play this here. You've got, it's popping on, maybe a little bit of a bounce there, and then it's static. And then you've got, you've used some nice effects to kind of have it break up and move off screen. Yep. And that's all fine. But what I'd say is all of this, it's a long title. Total, it's 7 seconds. You know, 7 seconds in today's world is a long time. Yeah. I might think about making it shorter, but let's see what we can do with that length. I think, first of all, you know, having a little rotation in there as it's moving, you know, between, well, instead of just static, it's going to be just rotating a bit. Mm-hmm. But what I'm going to suggest, somewhere in here, we could actually zoom way in to your whatever your fill is. I mean, let's try it. It's gonna look a little crazy, but it's gonna be fast. So I think right here, I'm just gonna have it go quite large. And then you can just fill the frame. Yeah, we don't have to go that large. And this is a playground, right? We can try something, and if we don't like it, we can change it. So now we have this title clip and that we're gonna use for this. So I'm gonna, you know, turn on multi-select, and then I'm gonna select the clips minus that little guy from your other title and copy them. And then we're going to go make a new project. We don't even need to name it. It's a temp. Yeah. Paste clips. There we got. Now that's the part we need to render for this effect, right?
Right, so we just render out the movie.
Mm-hmm. Render movies folder. We want a high quality one. Yeah. So I'm going to leave it 4K and high bit rate. And it's going to the render movies folder, so we're good to go. And when that's done, just take a second here. So we always have this project to come back to if we want to change a color or size or anything. But right now we can see that project is right here. Right, so now we've got this rendered clip. I'm gonna go back to your project. So now we need to find something to fill this with.
Terri and I went looking in story blocks for some footage to key into the letters. We ended up choosing a striking clip that looked kind of like the Star Wars hyperspace effect. We slid that in under the title and keyed out the green to reveal the clip below.
I mean, it's cool and everything, but you can keep that and do something else. Let's move these up a track. Let's go into get some background that we think could add something to that. So we want to go to backgrounds, maybe blue light.
Yeah, blue light, okay.
Okay, so we want, okay. Mm-hmm. Blue light. Let's try, I'm just gonna stick that guy in there. I'll just jump to here, delete that. All right, so can't see it right now, but we're gonna go in here because we can also add some blending modes in here, and I don't know, let's just play with them and see what we got. That one makes the snowflakes blue, color burn, linear burn. I'm kind of looking for something softer, mm-hmm. like that.
Yeah.
Now I don't like
That's
the color
hard to read,
of the.
No, it's really
yeah.
Fuzzy.
Yes, it is.
But it's pretty, but I mean, maybe that means changing outside. It looks nice on the inside.
About that. Now, I know you're gonna hate me, but there's one thing still missing. Besides the out effect. But I think this would be cool with like, whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
Terri's describing a vision of building some shimmer into this title animation here. We dug around in story blocks, searching on keywords like sparkle and glitter in the backgrounds library, and finally settled on a clip with some gorgeous animated light rays that looked like they might play nice in our piece.
Mm.
We layered these in over the title, then played around with the blending modes, just looking what each one does with the combination of elements we have.
I mean, that's not it, but you see how layering this
then
up is.
Then we animated that raised clip so that it flies across the screen.
Move it off like that, right? Maybe all the way off.
It's a nice soft edge on it.
Next, we juggled the order, putting that raised clip in underneath the title clip so that the effect only shows through those letters.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Whole new world, look at that. Works way better, right?
It's
much more
iterating, right? Mm-hmm. Just like you've been saying, just keep playing with it until you're like, oh, and happy accidents happen. You know, like most of the time it's not like, oh, I have this vision and it's gonna be great. It starts with that, but you gotta keep at it and keep adding things. Mm-hmm. And honestly, you could keep adding, you know what else you can
Terri
do?
Terri meant what she said, and she went on to show that by duplicating that title layer with the transparent letters, I could create an additional outline to my title, like this. And finally, we used the crop tool on that outline layer, animating that with a bit of keyframing, just to add that last little touch of motion and energy, the little cherry on top of the animation that we just invented.
What happens to me is I can spend hours doing this and I get so into something, I just keep digging and digging and digging. Say, like, oh, if it was just a little bit more like this or a little more like that. And it's just so much fun.
Yeah.
You'll probably be thinking of stuff that you would do. I've uploaded this project package to Dropbox, and anyone can download it and design this title, a title for my little piece here, your way. Help me think outside my own box. And if anyone actually takes up this goofy little challenge, when you're done, upload your LumaFusion project package or even just the video to Dropbox or YouTube or another SharePoint and drop a link in the comments here. Okay, now bullet pointing my takeaways from Terri's visit. If you're using effects like animation or dynamic styles, it should make sense in the context. Having drop shadows does help the text stand out, but
because the title is over a three-dimensional scene, the drop shadows don't like refer to anything. And that can take the viewer out of the scene before they ever get into it. Your effects and styles should add meaning, not just motion. So rather than a drop shadow, maybe we need to put something into the text that cues to the content of the video, something motorcycle-y or snowy. Iterate and scrap. Don't be afraid to take a bunch of time trying to make stuff work. It's not wasted time. This is how we learn what works for us. I've always hated throwing away work. But I honestly feel less awful about scrapping something that I've tried and tried and try again after doing this thrash with you here. I am super curious to see if anyone watching will throw their own edits into the ring. Hit the description. There's a link to download the title sequence project. It's a tiny download. We would love to see what you would do using LumaFusion to make this thing cooler. So thanks for letting me work that out with you. And happy editing.